Hi friends, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So the people who are coming for the first time, let me introduce myself. I am Neha Gupta. I have done my graduation from Lakshmibai College, Delhi University in English Literature. I have also pursued Masters in English Literature from IGNOU University. And after that, I have been engaged in this current affairs teaching for more than 1 year. And this on this note, let my introduction ends and let's begin this video. So the people who are coming for the first time, they should subscribe to our channel and hit this bell notification so that you guys know about the new uploads that we make on our channel. Also, you can join this Telegram group where we share free quizzes as well as resolve the queries of you guys. So if you have any query related to your exam preparation or related to strategy or anything related to your exam preparation or career guidance, you can ping us on this Telegram group. And the link of it is in description below. Now here is our first question, guys. To which country has India granted a line of credit of $448 million for 4 development projects in the field of road construction, sewerage treatment and information technology? So recently India and Uzbekistan. So the right answer is Uzbekistan. India and Uzbekistan have conducted their first bilateral virtual summit, and during that summit, a total number of 9 agreements were signed between India and Uzbekistan. And what is the purpose of those 9 agreements? The purpose is development. So there were renewable energy, cybersecurity, and MOUs on the similar lines were there, which were signed by India and Uzbekistan during their first bilateral virtual summit. And during that summit only, both these nations have have strengthened or reiterated their target of increasing their bilateral trade to $1 billion. So remember this thing, that both India and Uzbekistan are planning to increase their bilateral trade to $1 billion. Now apart from that, the line of credit of $448 million was also announced by India to Uzbekistan for its development projects in the field of road construction, sewerage treatment and information technology. So guys, here all the information related to this current news ends and my question for you begins. So your question is capital and currency of Uzbekistan. I hope that I haven't asked this question earlier, but in case if I have asked this question, then it is your revision only. So do tell me in the comment section below that what is the capital and what is the currency of Uzbekistan. Next question is, which of the following member of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization has started the movie series CinemaScope? So this highlighted SCO is for Shanghai Cooperation Organization. Now guys, which country has done so? Out of the 5 options, that is China, India, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Russia, it is India. Indian Embassy in Beijing, to be more precise. So this Indian Embassy in Beijing, China has started this CinemaScope movie series, and it is going to conduct this series till 2023, the year in which India is going to assume the chairmanship of SCO, Heads of Council, Heads of State Council. So I hope that you remember the demarcation between Head of State Council and Head of Government's Council within the SCO that I have discussed earlier in the month of November. Now, India is going to assume that chairmanship of Heads of State in 2023 of SCO, and until then, this Indian Embassy in Beijing is going to start, is going to premiere Indian movies dubbed in Russian language under this movie series called CinemaScope. So guys, we have discussed everything. Now let's take a look at the static facts, or we can say the static current facts related to SCO. So the recently, as you know, the 20th summit of SCO was held in the month of November. So guys, can you tell me that which country chaired or hosted that SCO summit of Heads of State Council? It is Russia. Russia is also the chair of SCO in 2020, remember that. And 19th summit of SCO heads of government was chaired by, was hosted by, not chaired, hosted by India and chaired by Indian Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu. Now, remember this thing that in the year 2020, Russia is the chair of SCO. Which country is the chair of SCO in 2021? It is Tajikistan. Tajikistan is going to chair SCO in 2021. So here we have discussed everything related to SCO. I'm not discussing the static facts because I assume that you already know those facts, like establishment year of SCO, the members, the president, etc. So these are some of the facts that we provide in the static GK, and I hope that you know these facts and have memorized it well. But in case if you have not done so, then do it immediately, because these are the various important organizations that can be asked in the examination. Now, my question for you is that who is the Indian ambassador to China? Since we are talking about Indian embassy in Beijing that has started this CinemaScope series, therefore it is relevant for you guys to know that who is the Indian embassy to China, Indian ambassador to China. So I'm leaving this question for you guys. Do toil a bit and give me your answers in the comment section. Now, this is a very simple question. Where is the CRPF's National Center for Divyang Empowerment located? First of all, what is this CRPF? What is the full form of CRPF? It is Central Reserve Police Force. So this Central Reserve Police Force is India's largest paramilitary force, and it has established this National Center for Divyang Empowerment. Now, where has it been established? It has been established in Telangana. To be more precise, in the Ranga Reddy district. Now, as the name of this center is clearly conveying the purpose of this establishment, of its establishment, that is National Center for Divyang, that is PWD, person with, people with disabilities, empowerment. Now, which people with, which PWD section is the center targeting? So the people who have served in the CRPF and have become disabled during their tenure, during their service at the CRPF, they will be provided skilling at the center. Now, this skilling will help them get employment as cyber police force or as para athletes. So these are some of the fields in which the disabled CRPF soldiers can go after getting skills. And that skills will be provided by this center, which has been set up at Ranga Reddy district in Telangana. So do remember these facts. So the next question is, what is the theme of International Mountain Day? So first of all, this International Mountain Day is observed on December 11th. And what is the theme for 2020? It is Mountain Biodiversity. So you would be thinking that why are we discussing this question, which was this day, which was held so many days back, that is on December 11th, and we are on December 16th. The reason behind that is the summit. A summit on mountain has taken place recently, and in that summit, this day was celebrated, or we can say the summit was held on the occasion of this day. So what is the summit? The summit is 9th. It is the edition of the summit. Sustainable Mountain Development Summit. So this is the 9th edition of this summit that was organized by Integrated Mountain Initiative. So this Integrated Mountain Initiative is basically a society of various organizations which works towards preserving or towards promoting the sustainable development in mountain areas, especially Himalayas. So this summit was organized by Integrated Mountain Initiative, and this summit also had its own theme. So what is the theme? Let's discuss that. So guys, this is the theme of this summit. emerging pathways for building a resilient post-COVID-19 mountain economy. So this is like a paragraph in itself. But this is the theme. We can't do anything. We have to memorize it because of the exams. So, emerging pathways for building a resilient post-COVID-19 mountain economy, adaptation, innovation, and acceleration. The basic idea behind this theme is to cope up with the challenges that are being thrown by the COVID-19 and to build the resilient economy, mountain economy. So, by the term mountain economy, it is referred to developing the mountain region as well as the economy. So that's all for this question. I hope that you would be able to remember the theme of this summit. So our next question is, which has become the first state in the country to have modernized fire safety certification process? So let's first discuss the answer of this question. There are five options: Madhya Pradesh, Telangana, Gujarat, Karnataka, and Kerala. Out of these five options, the right answer is option C, Gujarat. Now, recently, Gujarat government has announced its fire safety policy, which will be implemented from January 26, 2021. Now, guys, do you know that fire policy has three peculiar highlights? And what are those highlights? First highlight is that the private sector entities, private companies, as well as private engineers who are competent have been allowed by the state government to certify buildings as fire safe. So, first peculiar thing is allowing private entities or engineers to certify buildings as the fire safe building. Second highlight is that under the fire safety policy of the Gujarat government, four director of fires. So basically, this is a new post that will be created in Gujarat state. Director of fires in four zones of the state will be created. And what this post will do? This post will oversee that whether the buildings in their zone are compliant with the fire safety norms or not. So that would be the purpose of this director of fire. Now, and the third point is a portal. So the portal has been launched, or we can say the portal is being developed under the fire safety policy of the Gujarat government. So the fire safety compliance portal is the name of this portal, Fire Safety Corp. So this portal will provide the certificates as well as do the renew process of the fire certificate. So this is the way in which the state government has modernized its fire certification process. And these are the three highlights of the Gujarat fire safety policy that will be implemented from 26 January 2021. That's all for this question. Next question is really interesting as well as important. Which of the following country has co-hosted the International Climate Action Summit 2020 with UK, UN and France? So we have been given the three organizers of this summit as well as the host. So United Kingdom, United Nations and France are already the host of this summit. And the question is asking you the other two hosts of this summit. So the other two hosts are Chile and Italy. So option D is the right answer. Now, guys, do you know that this summit is celebrated, or we can say the summit is organized to celebrate the 5th anniversary of Paris Agreement? So, remember this thing? Paris Agreement, which was announced in 2015, which was introduced in 2015, has attained 5 years of age, and in order to celebrate its 5th anniversary, this International Climate Action Summit has been organized by UK, UN, France, Italy and China. Now, apart from this, do you guys know that UK is also going to host a very important summit of UN? So what is that summit? It is the COP26 of UN Climate Change Summit. Climate Change Conference. So UK is going to host this 26th edition of climate change conference. Now the exact location at the exact city in which this conference is going to be held, that is your task to tell me in the comment section below, because this has been told by me repeatedly in the sessions as well as in the Spotlight magazine. So now it's your task to tell me that in which city will UK host this 26th edition of UN climate change conference. Now for this question, that was all. And we are heading towards our next question. Recently, SEBI has formed a new department named Corporation Finance Investigation Department. Which of the following statement is correct about the department? So let's discuss or read out all the options out here. So the first option is it will investigate the insider trading. Option B says it will investigate financial accounting misstatements. C, it will investigate frauds committed by promoters of the company. D, it will investigate suspense accounting fraud. It will investigate shell companies. So out of these five types of corporate frauds, what kind of corporate fraud does this new agency aim to investigate? So the new department will investigate the frauds committed by promoters of the company. So you must have come up across Vijayamala, Cox and Kings and DHFL. These kinds of frauds are being committed by the promoters of the company. So therefore, in order to stop the promoters from misusing their powers, this new Corporation Finance Investigation Department has been set up by SEBI. Now, that's all for this question. The head of this department has not been revealed yet, but when it will be revealed, I will tell you in the session as well as in the morning, in the Spotlight magazine as well. Where will RBI set up an automated banknote processing center? So I don't think that it needs any kind of explanation what this center is. This is the banknote processing center, automated banknote processing center. Now, why is the need of having an automated banknote processing center? The need is the increasing amount of banknotes in the country. So basically, in order to handle that pressure of increasing banknotes in the country, this automated center is going to be set up by RBI in one of the cities from the option. So what is the right answer? It is Jaipur. In Jaipur, this automated center will be set up. So recently, it is just the announcement. Recently, UNESCO has decided to launch an international prize in the name of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. So guys, can you tell me that who is this person? And why is he so important? Because he has been in the news for past 1 year, and you know this thing, that who is this person? If you know, then do tell me, and if you don't know, then also let me know. I will tell you in the comment section, or if you need any explanation, then I will take up this person in the next session, because he's an important personality and a lot of things are going on to celebrate his 100th anniversary. So let's come back to the question. So recently, UNESCO has decided to launch an international prize in the name of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman with a prize money of $50,000. In which field will this prize be given? So this prize that UNESCO has announced will be given in the field of creative economy. So that's all for this question. I don't think that this award needs any kind of more explanation. This award has been announced by UNESCO in order to honor the individuals who are doing good in the field of creative economy. So that's all for this question. And here this session ends. I hope that you have really enjoyed the session. And if you have, then do tell me the answers of the questions that I have asked you in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching the video.